Can we compute a contour integral if we have an essential singularity inside our contour? We cannot use our formula for pole to compute the residue. We can, however, use the Laurent series of the function, as we'll see in this video. So in this example, we have the function f of z, the sines of 1 over z plus 1, so that will give me an essential singularity in z equals minus 1 times z minus 1 squared. And we have to integrate, and our contour is already given, it's a circle of radius 2, which means our essential singularity n minus 1 is inside our contour. And as you also see, the function is analytic everywhere else, so we have only one point where the function is not analytic, that's at z equals minus 1. So that means that we want to apply our theorem of residues. However, the problem is that in z equals minus 1 we have an essential singularity, so we want to use the Laurent series of the sines of 1 over z plus 1. Well, that is no problem, but the z minus 1 squared in front is a problem. We want the Laurent series in terms of powers of z plus 1. Now we have a z minus 1 squared. So what can we do? Well, no problem. Just rewrite our z minus 1 squared. So we want to rewrite it in terms of powers of z plus 1. So how can we do that? Well, our z minus 1 squared, we can work it out as z squared minus 2z plus 1. And then we can turn our z squared into a z plus 1 squared. Well, then we get z plus 1 squared. But then if you turn z squared in z plus 1 squared, you get z squared plus 2z plus 1. So we get a plus 2z plus 1 too much, so we have to subtract that. And we still had our minus 2z plus 1 left from over here. So now we have 1 z plus 1 squared. And you see the minus 1 and plus 1 over here cancel out. So we have a z plus 1 squared, which is nice because we want the powers of z plus 1 minus 4z, which is not nice because it's not the power of z plus 1. But we can do the same trick because we know z equals z plus 1 minus 1. So our minus 4z equals minus 4 times z plus 1 minus 1 times the minus 4 equals a plus 4. And now we are happy because we have expressed our z minus 1 squared as a z plus 1 squared minus 4 times the z plus 1 plus 4. So in terms of powers of z plus 1. So now we can form the Laurent series of our function because our f of z equals the z minus 1 squared becomes a long expression now, becomes z plus 1 squared over here, minus 4 times z plus 1 plus 4 times our sine. We can expand our sine because you know sine x equals x minus x cubed over 3 factorial plus x to the power 5 over 5 factorial. But we only need, in the end, we only need the term with the 1 over z plus 1. So we don't have to go that far in the Laurent expansion. So we need only the first two terms. So here we have the first two terms of the sine times the z plus 1 squared. Again, the first two terms of the sine times now the minus 4 times z plus 1. And again, the first two terms of the sine. And as you know, the residue of f of z, it's just the coefficient in front of the z plus 1. Well, let's see, why do we have powers of 1 over z plus 1? Well, if you look at the middle term, we have z plus 1 over z plus 1, which gives something to the power 0, plus z plus 1 times 1 over z plus 1 cubed, which gives 1 over z plus 1 squared. So you don't have any terms with 1 over z plus 1. So no contributions from the middle term. We do have some contributions from the first term and from the third term. So what do we have? We have, if we want to form a power of 1 over z plus 1, we have our z plus 1 squared over here times 1 over z plus 1 cubed, which gives us 1 over z plus 1, times a minus 1 over 3 factorial, so a minus 1 over 6. Okay, so we have a minus 1 over 6. And we have a power of 1 over z plus 1, also from our last term. We have 4 times 1 over z plus 1, so we also have a 4 over z plus 1, which gives us a plus 4. So the residue is the sum of those two, 4 plus minus 1 over 6 equals 24 over 6, minus 1 over 6 equals 23 over 24. And then we can apply the theorem of residues, the integral along C of f dz equals 2 pi I times the sum of the residues, which is only one residue, so 2 pi I times the residue in minus 1 equals 23 over 24. So our conclusion is our integral equals 2 pi I times the residue, so 2 pi I times 23 over 24 equals 23 pi I over 12.